They are one of the most complex chemical weapons remaining in the United States, M55 rockets, one of three types of chemical munitions stored at the Bluegrass Army Depot in Kentucky, which will be destroyed at the Bluegrass plant.
The difference between the projectiles and the rockets is it just requires such many more steps within the munitions demilitarization building itself.
At 6.5 feet tall, the rockets are twice as long as projectiles. Weighing nearly 60 pounds, they contain a rocket motor, fused warhead, and 10 pounds of nerve agent. These weapons were originally intended for long-range targets on the battlefield.
The rockets were never intended to be dismantled. The original intent was to fire them from the M91 launcher.
Therefore, dismantling the rockets and neutralizing the agent requires specialized machinery, which includes Bluegrass-specific equipment.
That first step is actually unpacking the munitions from the enhanced on-site container in our unpack area.
From there, the rockets move down a feed line heading to the explosive containment vestibule.
That first process is where we'll actually take the rocket and we'll actually segment it into two different pieces. It's called the rocket cutting machine. From that machine is where we actually separate the warhead from the rocket motor itself. And the rocket motor itself will be sent off to the motor packing room for further storage and further processing at a later date.
Meanwhile, the warhead containing the energetics or explosives and the chemical agent continues to the explosive containment room.
Where it'll be punched and drained of its agent. That agent will be sent off to a holding tank. From that holding tank, it goes into what we call our agent neutralization system that'll actually use to destroy the agent itself.
While the nerve agent is neutralized, the rocket shear machine cuts up the remaining drained rocket. And a robot brings those pieces to the energetics batch hydrolyzers, which neutralizes the parts and any residual agent. Remaining liquids are further processed. And remaining solids, such as nuts and bolts that did not dissolve in the hydrolyzers, are collected in a hopper.
And then further on, it goes into the metal parts treater for last part of that treatment.
During systemization or testing, the Bluegrass team is testing these processes and specialized equipment, which will safely dismantle these obsolete and complex chemical weapons.